Well, this just happened overnight. Actually, a little earlier than that. Just a few minutes ago. All right, 10:30. I'm looking at my clock. All hell is breaking loose as China preparing for war with the United States of America. Air Force Secretary says. That's not even the worst of it. As I'm like filming, then I get stuff coming through my feed. Take money out of banks. JP Morgan, which is actually a story I'm going to cover. But it looks like Ninja beat me to it because he just sits there in his car and talks all day. He doesn't spend the time on the hair. I mean, he is getting there. I mean, a little Viagra gel, that'll help it. Rock hard all day, but I have a plethora of news stories for you guys. Economic data. So hopefully you guys are drinking and sitting down. What do you guys want first? We'll go flip some money here. Oh, it's economic data. Also, for the trolls in the audience, let me put some fire out for you that say, man, Bravo, if I just wouldn't have listened to you and just been in the market for the last few years, I would have made so much money. Can I just say to you, go eat a big bag of farts because you're a liar. You are actually underneath. I mean, break even from August 2020. Did you see this? August 2021, that would be right here. But if you got in a little higher, right, in September, which we were in, you're underneath. This was over 2 years ago because you did not take advantage of the up. You did not take advantage of the down. You did not then take advantage of the up. You're still break even. If you learn how to frack and swing trade, you would have been up 25% and then another 25%. That would be 50%. Also, if you want to take advantage of today's offer of 60% off on how to swing trade to maybe fix those digits, link in the description. And if you are on the couch of what I trade every day, that's the next troll is like, show us what you trade every day. So I had to come up with a bear market and a bull market. Those are going up to 40. Right now they're 30. You'll be grandfathered in. Lock it before it goes to 40. It'll never go back down to 30. It'll never go back down to 20. For those of you that locked at 20, congratulations, you're smart. For those of you that are taking advantage of the 30, you're also smart. But moving on to the depressionary economic data, the politicians will be, oh, I got some good politician ones for you. They're like, everything's fine. Push the red button, Joey B. Let's start this war. The share of households. And actually, squirrel moment, real quick. That's what he looks like when he's like, yeah, I'm not going to war, right? Yeah, Biden, Vietnam, U.S. I'm not over here. It's not me. Probably won't help any election, right? Would I get I would get reelected. Oh, that's great. The share of households. Sorry, now we're back. I just saw the squirrel. I wanted to get over there because it was funny. It came into my head and I wanted to show you. Households reporting, it's harder to obtain credit than a year ago. Increased to the highest level since the survey was ever launched. 2013. I bet you this, where you guys are currently at, would beat 07, would beat 08. Would even be beat the last recession there. And then the other recession that we had over here, but they're like, oh, two negative GDP prints. Well, we're not going to use that anymore. Kinda like China, where they're like, oh, so fifth. I just saw a report. Sorry, another scroll. Half of everyone with college degrees that are exiting and looking for jobs can't get one. Also known as youth unemployment. But Bravo, why is this even important? Credit. Credit in a debt-based system is like the meat of the hamburger. Or if you are vegan and you are a male, it's like the meat inside of your taco. But you don't get either because you're vegan, so make the meat soy. But anyways, it's very important. And it is, going away. Well, no, I'm sorry, it's gone. And we have a lot of things gone, going away. Net shares of domestic bank tightening lending standards. Here we go again. Thank you to GOAT for putting this on Twitter. And you can see every time the gray bars, every time they do this, we go into a recession. This time, you're lucky if it's a recession. I'm telling you, I'm saying depression. Could be wrong. A war will fix it though. So then scratch that. When the bombs start dropping, all bets are off. Market rips higher. Commodities rip higher. Your gold and silver, for you guys that are stacking, you win at that. There was the 08. That was the double zeros over there. There was the 80s back there. That is what we just had when we just locked down. And we're back up there once again. And that's domestically. You should see what's happening around the world. Euro. Household credit growth. Look at that. Is that like off a cliff, or is that just that's a soft landing? Every chart that I'm going to show you says no soft landing. When you see the lines going like this straight into the ground, it's not going to be soft. Median sales price of homes sold for the United States. Here we go. 70s crash, 80s crash, 90s crash. You see, like 2008 crash. Look at 08 compared to where we are right now. Oh, we're fine. Everything's fine. Look, guys, come on. Whoever's saying this is soft, well, you need some Viagra. And you see, what is happening is liquidity is being pulled out and moved and destroyed, and it's sad. We're constricting. We're all on a diet, because a couple years ago you weren't on a diet, and the governments were feeding you like crazy, and you're like, wow, now it's going in reverse, but harder than I have so many Viagra jokes today, harder than 1928. That would be the Great Depression. And it is globally, it is around the world. All central banks are like, this is a great idea. Let's crash this mother. And this is at the exact same time that the Fed's like, hey, you need to have liquidity. That's what they're saying to Jamie. That's what they're saying to Bank of America. That's what they're saying to all these guys. And the banks are like, we're gonna fail. And then the Fed's like, oh, boo-hoo. Oh, you're gonna fail? That's so sad. Maybe we'll be the lenders of last resort. Hey, great idea. See, it's kind of always been a fight between the Fed and the banks, even though the banks own the Fed. Now the Fed's like, ooh, ha-ha, we got a scheme. Now that we got Fed Now, and we have digital, and we have this, and we have that, who's gonna win this one? But coming in from Jamie Dimon, right? On fire. The fires of hell. What's going on, Mr. Demon? Who's stock? Oh, JPM up. I wonder if you guys could have saw that in the charts. Jamie Dimon says it is a huge mistake to think the economy will boom with so many risks out there. Well, Hugh's son, who figured this one out, you are correct. That is why I come to you every single day giving you the charts, giving you the macro, and then teaching you how to trade it, even though the charts and the macro won't really help out too much. But it is kind of fun, like, to look out and see the thunderstorms that are approaching. But as Mr. Dimon says, while the U.S. economy is doing well, no, it's not. I could talk to anyone on the streets, and they aren't surviving. But thanks, Jamie. Guess you're probably not out there figuring out what, I mean, right, when you make quadrillions a year, you're just like, I think we're all doing great. I just keep buying all these banks. This is awesome. It would be a huge mistake to believe that it will last for years. Okay. All right. Well, it's the dream is over. I am sorry. Topping his concerns includes central banks reining in liquidity programs, right, via quantitative tightening. Now it's like, sorry, Jamie, you got to keep these things called money inside your bank that the people deposit, but you don't do that. What you do is you loan it out. Well, your money's not in there? What? Are you kidding me? No. And then you buy mortgage-backed securities. How dare you? And then you buy bonds that are all upside down. Wait until that all, you know, flips. And then we have governments around the world spending like drunken sailors, which is fine, because if the people are too stupid to know that this, when they spend, who's gonna pay for it? Well, that would be per you, $254,178 on top of what you already owe, on top of a deficit of $2 trillion. It's getting worse. Bravo, how do I fix this? You cannot take a paycheck. Because if you take a paycheck, they'll take the money out. Like, let's say 55%. If you're at a 38% tax bracket and you live in California with another 14%, or they'll throw on another percent just for good measures because you're actually making enough to survive, 38 plus 15, I believe, is above half. Here is the solution. Mow people's lawn. They give you cash. Oh, what cash? Well, don't do that. Then government will come after you. But now I'm just trying to take something so simple. Mow a lawn. You make $100 a month. You mow 10 people's lawns. You make $1,000 a month. Now, I know you're thinking, you're like, that's too much money. Okay, they're big lawns, right? And I don't want to do that. Right, exactly. That's where you take that $1,000 a month that you're making and you hire someone to do what you don't want to do. You pay them half of what you were making. I'm not giving up half. Come on, you're not working now. You pay them half. Well, that's only 500. Well, now you find 10 more lawns. Hey, now we're back up to 1,000. Bravo, I don't want to mow lawns. I just want to do something online where I click the button. Oh, okay. Well, then sell pink balls. Or if you're married, sell blue balls. Or sell a ball with a string on it. Or sell a ball with it called Chuck It. Kind of like how they say don't recreate the wheel. See, it's a wheel. Create it. And you want to know how much they make? I don't know. I didn't click the button because I have Thursday night football in 50, because I got to sit there on my butt and root for a team that I don't own, even though it's a franchise, which you should also own franchises. Those are businesses. And then people will support you. That always confuses me. I'm like, when the Raiders go from one place to another, do you follow? And do you understand? It's a business. It's a franchise that a dude like me spends money and buys, and then you're like, yeah, which I'm down for that, but I want you doing this. Don't spend your time sitting on your butt. Sorry, go start a business. How much are you making? They're making $114,000 a month on that one, $59,000, $87,000, $83,000. This guy's selling a lot of balls. 90, look at all these. Boy, oh boy. And also, $100, so you have no excuse for my $1,000 Amazon course. Yes, many, many, many of people have paid $1,000. I know that's not fair. Well, no, neither is life, but for you today, $100. So you can learn, you don't have excuses, and you don't have to own office buildings, which is great. Isn't this great? I own day spas, lots and lots of employees. I mean, go look at my hair, right? You'd think I might have something to do in the hair industry. I did. But I don't, brick and mortar is horrible, terrible. It is going to get worse if you're holding it right now. The crashing office market, and you can launch a ball. That's amazing. When I found that, I'm like, I'm all out. I was out of everything. I'm all interwebs. Mom will deepen the economic doom loop for American cities. Hopefully you're not living in a city. Economist says, so everyone gets to lose. The banks get to lose. The businesses get to lose. But you don't get to lose because you're starting an online business. And I don't care. You're like, oh, I hate Amazon. Well, then launch it on your own plot. Do Shopify. For me, it's easy. It just, what's the easiest? And like mowing a lawn, I'm making $1,000. But you don't want to give up half of your profit. How easy is it? I'll just do 10 more lawns. I'll go knock on some doors. You just keep going, and then you launch more balls. Some blue ones, some yellow ones, some pink ones. Kyle Bass says U.S. banks to lose. So the banks are going to lose. And the people that decided that they thought that would be a really good passive income to own office buildings are going to lose $250 billion in office holdings. That is going to cripple the world. Guaranteed. Along with student loan debt. Little cripple. That's like, you can swipe, you can't see, I'm kicking my leg, which moderately hurt. That's like someone swiping your leg. That was just a little bit. This one is like dropping a gigantic boulder on your head. Then getting back to this too, when I see these things, sorry, I guess I'm bad when, they're like, every auto job, a good job, 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 we need jobs. We're going to complain. We're going to strike. Sell the poster boards. Sell picket signs. I don't care. Sell the t-shirt this guy's wearing. Sell something. Do it. Try to get out of that system that they have just ground into you since kindergarten. Be an employee. Sit at a desk. Copy, copy, copy your whole life. From kindergarten all the way through university. You get a doctorate degree and you're damn good at copying stuff. averting, which I did. And then I taught it. I know. I'm calling the kettle black. Averting auto strike hinges on pay raises to cover inflation. Be on the other side. Oh, inflation. I'm going to raise my prices. You see? See, smart people are on the other side. They don't care. Inflation? Oh, it's so bad that I have to double my, which then I bring my price, you know, my course to $100. Because I love you guys and I just want you to do it. I want you to, I don't care. Again, go mow lawns. And you don't have to go to your employer like, I need a pay raise. And also, believe it or not, when you're on the other side, you actually are like, oh, a war. Wow. Okay, so I'm going to make more money, which is horrible. I know, right? That's what they're doing. I'm not saying it's terrible. I was in the military. I had to fight for these guys, these psychopaths. I get it. I'm just trying to help you on the other side that if then, then what happens? Biden in Vietnam, U.S. president not trying to start a Cold War with China. I mean, what would that solve? Well, you get reelected. What would it solve in China? Well, the economy would grow. That's great. So you see, it's all against you. NATO prepares for biggest military exercise since Cold War and close to Russia. This is the world, guys. Like what I said at the very beginning of the video, China preparing for war with the United States of America. This just came out. Also, my prayers go out to you if you signed up like I did. I was Air Force, Chair Force, Air Force. That you're fighting for someone else's money. That was actually one of my eye-opening experiences. When I was in there, I'm like, I don't want to do this. I want to start businesses. And probably within 12 months of being out of the military, I owned my first day spa. It kind of put a little bit of that fire underneath your boo-ha-ha. And it was like, I started a business every single year. So anyways, you guys, start businesses, trade equities, learn this stuff. I love you, and I will see you tomorrow. Because I work every single day of my life, even though I don't have to. And the crowd goes wild because they need that kind of humor, like blue balls and pink tacos and all those kind of things. And I'll see you tomorrow.